So today, I would like to present the OpenStack Orchestrate service chain. And my name is Suhun Yun from Manishi. Then I'm working for the VTN project in OpenDayRight. And hopefully so everybody can learn something from this session. And then we are open for the other people to join this VTN project. And then also want to work with other project in OpenDayRight communities. In this presentation, there will be the two parts. The first one is a virtual tenant network in OpenDayRight. So first of all, I would like to provide the overview of the virtual tenant network using the VTM models. Then I would like to discuss the, how the service chain will be performed in the OpenDayRight with the VTN. Then integration with OpenStack will be presented. Then in the second part of the session, the Thai sitting here will show you some more detail with the demonstration, right? Then let me start with what's a virtual tenant network and then how it works with the service chain. So VTN project is the first project when we established the OpenDayRight communities in 2 years ago. Then basically it has two components. One is a VTN manager, which is a part of the OpenDayRight base controller. Then it enables a multi-tenancy in the network and also provides the end-to-end pass controls. Then this VTN manager will talk with a VTN coordinator, which is an application on top of the OpenDayRight controller. Then VTN coordinator provides the northbound API to the application. And also it maps the VTN model to the OpenDayRight APIs. And it also provides the control, the multiple SDN controller capabilities. So VTN itself has so many rich functionality, but today I would like to focus on the service chain and an OpenStack part. Then if you are interested in more about the VTN, all the information will be available in a VTN project in the OpenDayRight Wix site. And then please contact us if you are interested in more detail. Then many people already saw this diagram from the Lithium release. And then VTN project has been participated in from the first release, helium, and then hydrogen, and then lithium. Then you can see on the top side in the network application, and VTN coordinator sit on the the top layer next to the OpenStack neutrons. Then you can see the VTN manager, which is a part of the network service. So today we have so many active projects in the OpenDayRight, so it might be very difficult to find a VTN manager, but that it's in the sit in the core DayRight controllers. Then in this Lithium release, VTN project work to the switch from ADSL to the MDSL, and also work with OpenStack Neutron, and then OVSDB and then OpenFlow in the southbound protocols. And by working together such component, it will provide the OpenFlow-based service chain use cases. It will be demonstrated later in this presentation, right? Then let me tell you more about some VTN. So first of all, so VTN provides a multi-tenant and traffic isolation and provides an abstraction of the physical networks. So first of all, the VTN will discover all the physical topologies in the data plane using OpenFlow with LLDPs. Then such switching resource will be logicalized in the SDN controller and then open to the users and application to define and create the abstracted logical networks. So in this slide, there are two VTNs are defined. And first VTN has a server A to server B with one optimizer and firewall and load balancers. In the VTN2, it was defined in server C to server D with DDoS appliance and then firewalls. Then, and you can see some several VTN model in this diagram that in the next page as defined. So this is a list of the VTN models from the VTN project. So first VTN, which is a logical representation of the virtual networks. Then if you want to define the layer 2 network, you can use the vBridge for such representations. And also vRouter provides you the layer 3 routing capability as a logical entities. And then also if you want to define the virtual tunneling capabilities, you can use a vTunnel and also vTap as an endpoint. And also you can bypass some network by using the vBypass. And then finally, the interface is the endpoint of the node. So it can be representing the virtual machine, container, or servers, and then all the host in the networks. Then by using and then combining then these all the components, you can define your own logical networks. Then back to the previous slide, you can see in the VTN number one, in addition to the such network appliance or services, you can see the layer 3, the virtual routers in the middle, and also the bridge in the VTN 1, and also VTN 2. Then this is completely up to you what kind of the virtual network you want to create. Then you can use these components to define the to satisfy your requirement. So this is a VTN's flexibility to the users to define some logical networks. And then it completely hides the complexity of the physical topologies, and also these two tenants are completely isolated each other. Right? So that's the definition of the VTN. Then after you define the network, now it's time to program the network. Then in order to define such actions, there is a two-step. First, you define the matching condition using the 12 tuples. So from layer 1 physical port to layer 2 and layer 3, and then as well as layer 4 logical port numbers. Then combining these 12 tuples, you can define the matching condition. Then define the, your intent or action, how to manage your packet. Then this combination of the matching condition and the action can be applied to the VTN, or if you want to apply such a policy only to the certain layer 2 domain, you can apply such policy to the virtual bridge. Then in this example, if the traffic comes to the VTN, and you can define the matching condition action as a forward to the destinations. Or you can drop the packet for the ACL purpose. Otherwise, you can mark the packet for the QoS case, and then finally, you can redirect to the certain network services for the service chain use cases. So by combining these actions, you can program your definition of the network behaviors with your policies, right? Then let me tell you more little bit about the traffic redirections. Then if you have some intent to redirect a certain traffic, you can define the VTN mode configuration as in right side. The first, you define the VTN tenant 1, and then you can define the, this is a layer 2 domain, so you can define the vBridge. Then you can define the flow filter inbound direction, and also you can specify the sequence number for the priorities. Then define flow list as a A, and then action as a redirect to the V terminal interface 1. So this configuration can be done in using the CLI or REST API, and then hopefully the GUI in the sometime in the near futures. Then this configuration can be visualized as in the bottom side of the user interface. So from server A to server B, and then that is a layer two domain, so which is connected to the virtual bridge. Then if some certain flow only go to the virtual terminal one, and which is an, physically the server C. So this policy can be implemented to the, on top of the VTN as applications. Then using these capabilities, we can enable the service chain on the VTN. And back to the same example of the network topologies. Then if you have some, this red flow going through the one optimizer, firewall, and then load balancers. Then otherwise, you can define like a blue flow only go to the firewalls. And also the in the VTN2, another green flow go to the DDoS appliance and firewall, then finally go to the destinations. So by combining the, your matching condition and then policies, you can define your own service chain policies, and then you can apply that such policy on the logical network views. Then again, obviously you don't need to configure the, every single switch in the network to do this. This is one of the benefits of the SDN controller with VTNs. Then let me tell you about then how the integration with OpenStack is done here. And this picture shows OpenStack and then OpenDayRight architectures. And you can see the OpenStack site. We have a Neutron and then ML2 plugins, and which is connected to the Neutron interface in the OpenDayRight controllers. So this is already existing the component in OpenDayRight. Then we added the VTN manager to talk with the Neutron interface. Then also the VTN manager work with the VTN coordinator, which will be the connected to the application through the REST APIs. Application can be the graphical user interface or service chain policies. Then these two, Neutron interface and VTN coordinators work with the VTN manager. Then a VTN manager will configure the, all the open flow switch in the network using the open flow protocol plugin in the southbound and as well as the OVSDBs. Right? Then let me show you some step-by-step how the OpenStack integration is done here. And first of all, so user can have some wants to deploy the virtual machine firewall in the network. In this case, the Neutron dashboard user configures, deploys, creates new virtual machines. Then such information come to the VTN managers through the ML2 plugin and then Neutron interface. Then in meanwhile, the OpenStack will create a virtual machine in the networks. Then this creation also go to the VTN manager from the southbound side. Then by having this information, VTN manager can map the OpenStack component to the VTN models. For example, the network in the OpenStack can be mapped to the VTN. And also the subnet can be mapped to the VBridge, and port mapped to the interface. So this mapping can be done automatically in the VTN manager side. So by doing this, then this newly created virtual machine can be ready to provide the services. Then now you can define your service chain policies. And for example, if you want to redirect the flow XYZ to this newly created firewall, then such request go to the VTN manager through the VTN coordinators. And then in this VTN manager, it will create the matching condition and then action for in this request. So flow XYZ will be defined to direct to the firewall. So this creation will be automatically distributed to the all the switches in the networks using open flow protocols, right? Then switch can have their own such matching condition and action in the flow entries. then once you have such traffic to the switch, it will check the matching condition. Then if it hits the request, then it will be redirected to the firewall. Then back to the switch and then forwarded to the final destinations. So this is kind of the overview of the how the OpenStack based virtual machine can be used as a service function in the network, and how we can redirect such a traffic to the service chain use cases, right? Then once again, so this OpenStack based service chain is completely open flow based solution, which is different from the other project in the Open Daylight community, and then a specific you know, use case using the VTN project, okay? So now this is an overview, and then let me switch to the type for the more specific demo features.
Hi, I'm Hideyuki Tai from NEC. I'm a contributor to Open Daylight project, especially for VTN project and NIC NYC internet project. Today, I would like to show you how service function chaining works on these VTN features. So, okay, this slide shows the VTN features which I would like to highlight in this demonstration. The first point is the seamless integration with OpenStack. As he explained, so VTN Manager supports OpenStack integration. It means that you don't need to manually define virtual network when you are using OpenStack. So once you create a logical network in OpenStack, VTN Manager receives this information and automatically created virtual bridge, and based on this virtual bridge information, VTN Manager automatically installs flow entries into OpenFlow switch you deploy. Okay, so the second point is the ability to insert service functions dynamically. So VTN Manager provides a way to kind of intent-based policy, so you can easily change the network policy and insert service functions dynamically. Third point is, to do this thing, VTN feature does not require NSH capability. It means that you don't need to buy NSH capability and deploy your environment. VTN feature just work with OpenFlow switches. The fourth point is the ability to visualize end-to-end flows. So not just listing flow entries in each switch, VTN Manager can list end-to-end flows from host to host. So I will show you how VTN feature list, how VTN feature visualizes end-to-end flows the later of this demonstration. Okay, so this slide shows the overview of this demonstration. So the lower half of this slide shows the physical equipment. On this demonstration, I deployed three OpenStack nodes and running five VM instances, including two service function VMs. So in this demonstration, to make it clearly obvious, this service function just inserted 200 milliseconds delay when this guy forwards packets. So it means that so when the packet goes through this service function VMs, the traffic is added 200 milliseconds delay, so you can easily see when the packet goes through this service function chain, service function VMs. And in the demonstration, I These OpenStack nodes are connected with OpenFlow switches. I've deployed 10 OpenFlow switches. OpenFlow switches in there. So this is a little bit complicated, but you don't need to manage. You don't need to understand this a little bit complicated network, because these OpenFlow switches, all switches are controlled by VTN manager running in OpenDelight controller. So what you need to do is just define virtual network via API of VTN manager. So the upper half of this slide shows a virtual network, which I will define in this demonstration. At this time, there is one virtual bridge, and host 1, host 2, and host 3 running in OpenStack nodes are connected with this virtual bridge. It means that packets from these hosts are forwarded like there is a normal layer 2 switch. So VTN manager is seamlessly integrated with OpenStack. So when I created a logical network in OpenStack, this virtual bridge configuration is automatically created by VTN manager. So anyway, so since there is a virtual bridge, packets from host 1 to host 3 is forwarded like this. So receiving this configuration, VTN manager automatically installs flow entries like this. So packets go through these switches. In the demonstration, so to insert service functions, first I need to create virtual terminals for service functions like this. So this it means that register service functions with VTN manager. So in this scenario, I don't want packets to be forwarded to these service functions without I explicitly configure service function chaining. So these virtual terminals are not connected with the virtual bridge. So it means that at this time, the packets from this host does not reach to this service function chaining. But we have virtual terminals. It means that we are ready to insert service function dynamically to this traffic. Okay, so at this point, I configure traffic redirection. To do that, I need to specify the target traffic, and we need to define a service function chain. So as the target traffic, in this demo, I use source IP address and destination IP address. As a source IP address, I specify host 1's IP address, and as a destination IP address, I'm specifying the host 3's IP address. And to insert service function 1 to this traffic, later in the script, I specify the service function 1. So in the point of view of a virtual network, the packet should be forwarded like this. And receiving this configuration, VTN manager running in OpenDelight controller automatically send OpenFlow messages and try to update flow entries into these switches. So packets from host 1 is really forwarded to service function 1 and to host 3. So at this time, this service function guy adding 200 milliseconds delay, so we can see we can see the communication from host 1 to host 3 is really go through this service function. Okay, this slide explains software component in this demonstration. So in this demo, I'm using OpenDLI to Lithium and I'm installing these two features in Calaf console. Also, I'm using VTN coordinator, which is also contained in Lithium release. And I'm using GUI of a VTN coordinator. And also, I'm using OpenStack Juno version. And this slide shows how I deploy these software components. So as I explained, there are three OpenStack nodes. And in OpenStack control nodes, there are Neutron component and ML2 plugin for OpenDLI. And in the demo, I just using the GUI of OpenStack node of OpenStack to change the OpenStack configuration. And also, I'm using scripts to call REST API of VTN to change virtual network configuration to insert service function dynamically. Okay, so demonstration part. Actually, I've recorded the demonstration, so let me start the video. So this is the OpenStack GUI, and first I created a logical network and launched VM instances on this network. This operation is really normal operation, nothing special. So here I'm just specifying the allocation pools of IP address for this network. And the configuration is done, and a logical network is created on OpenStack. After that, on this logical network, I'm launched VM instances, 5 VM instances. This operation is also normal operation on OpenStack GUI, nothing special. So I just skipped because there are same operation. Okay, at this point, I have 5 VM instances, and 2 of them are service function VMs, which insert just 200 milliseconds delay. Okay, and now I tried to send packets from host 1 to host 3. At this time, I didn't configure service function chaining, so packets are forwarded like this without any big delays. There are just like few milliseconds delay. So since VTN manager is seamlessly integrated with OpenStack, so here I just creating a logical network on OpenStack GUI, but actually this information, VTN manager gets this information, and based on this information, automatically created flow entries, automatically installed flow entries into OpenFlow switch, so these packets are forwarded based on flow entries. Okay, also I opened host 2's console and again tried to send ping packets from host 2 and host 3. And it also worked. Okay. And now I'm showing the GUI of VTN. So here, this GUI shows virtual network configuration. So at this time, there is one virtual bridge, which is automatically created. And also, this virtual bridge have several virtual interfaces. Each virtual interface is associated with virtual host, virtual instance, which I launched in OpenStack nodes. So VTN manager has this kind of information. So VTN manager know to which port packet forwarded. Okay, for example, this shows the information about a particular interface of a virtual bridge. And there is information about switch ID and port ID for the virtual machine instance, which I launched in OpenStack GUI. And also, this VTN GUI can show physical network topology like this. This is a physical topology which Open Daylight Controller detects. This GUI just gets this network topology information from Open Daylight Controller. And not just showing physical topology. So VTN manager has a capability to list end-to-end flows. And this GUI visualizes this information. For example, among the list of end-to-end flows, I choose the end-to-end flow from host 1 to host 3. And this blue lines shows which switches this traffic go through. And at this time, I didn't yet configure a service function chaining policy, so the traffic from host 1 goes to host 3 directly. Okay, so this is a console, and on this console, I run script. This script creates virtual terminals using VTN API. So it means that define register service function with VTN manager. To do that, I need to specify switch ID and port ID, port IDs of the service functions. So using this switch ID and port ID information, VTN manager knows to which port packets will be forwarded. So here I create virtual terminals for two service functions. Like this, and these operations. So let me go back to the slide, and so this script means this behavior, creating virtual terminals, which is associated with service functions. Okay, and now we have virtual terminals for these two service functions. So now I'm ready to do service function chaining. I'm ready to define a service function chain. So first, here I try to insert service function 1 to the traffic from host 1 to host 3. So in this script, I specify the IP address of host 1 and host 3. And this script requires the number of service functions to insert to create a service function chain. And after that, I enter the name of service function. Actually, this is I defined on the previous script. Okay, now the configuration for service function chaining is done. So you can see suddenly the delay, the 200 milliseconds delay happened. The ping traffic from host 1 to host 3. I'm opening the console of host 1. But in the configuration for service function chaining, I explicitly specify the host 1's IP address. So actually, this is not host 1. This is the console of host 2, and this shows the ping packets from host 2 to host 3. And this, in this communication, the 200 milliseconds delay is not inserted like this. So in this demo, I used the IP address as a classifier of service function chaining. But actually, so VDN manager is using OpenFlow. So whatever available in OpenFlow, we can use as a matching condition like TCP port, UDP port, or ICMP code, ICMP type, whatever we can use as a classifier for the target traffic for the service function chaining. Yeah.
So let's say host 1 and host 2 are clients.
Yeah.
And I want a service chain to go to internet. Do I have to create a service chain for host 1 to go to yahoo.com and another service chain to go to google.com? Can I just make a service chain for host 1 to go?
Yeah, you can do it.
Yeah.
Yeah, in this demo scenario, I'm just thinking the internal traffic of the data center. So in my script requires source IP address and destination IP address. But within API, you can just specify the, for example, source IP, or just specify the destination IP address, and you can set the IP address of yahoo.com or like that. I skipped this operation, but to know the port ID of these service functions, I checked the OpenDaylight GUI. Or also, I can get this information using RESTconf of OpenDaylight. Yeah, I think OpenFlow plugin or other application expose this information. Okay. Could you say okay? So now VTN manager does not have a capability to automatically find a service function. So I have to tell which port service function is connected.
Okay.
So
you have a sort of a YAML file, JSON file to specify that kind of requirement?
Yeah, we can use REST API. Okay. Yeah, right now not in Lichem, this is not done via RESTconf, but yeah, to do that, I think we need to change, we need to extend a plugin in OpenStack side. And the VTN manager supports this new plugin. So, and operator must, in OpenStack GUI, operator must specify this VM is a service function, like, and maybe I think operator need to tell the OpenStack the service function type, like firewall or like that. And this information must be forwarded to VTN manager, like that, yeah. Yeah, I mean, so this demonstration shows how, this demonstration really show the service function chaining, but not, to be honest, not all part is done from OpenStack. Some configuration like creating virtual terminals and configure traffic redirection, these parts are configured by using directly calling VTN API. But other part, other basic part like creating a virtual bridge for virtual host on OpenStack, these part are completely integrated with OpenStack. Yeah.
Is that a port of the switches that you're using, some ports of the switches that you're using?
Okay, so at this point, I've already configured the service function chain. And so on the VTN GUI, we can see how the traffic from host 1 go through host 3. Actually, the packet from host 1 go to the service function VM instances, and after that, go to host 3. So this blue line shows the end-to-end flow from host 1 to host 3. And this is virtual network configuration of VTN GUI. And now, virtual terminals are created for service functions. So these virtual terminals was created when I executed the script. And you can, okay, so next I configured for the second service function chain. So at the second service chain, the target traffic is from host 2 to host 3. And at this time, I inserted two service functions like this. Service 1 and service 2. And now I opened the console of host 2. And as you can see, the delay from host 2, host 3, was the delay was 400 milliseconds because this traffic went through two service functions which inserted 200 milliseconds. So now only the traffic from host 2 to host 3 has having 400 delays in total. And also you can see how packet goes through in the view of a virtual network. So like this, the packets from host 2 go through the virtual terminals which are associated with service function 1, and after that the packet went through virtual terminals which are associated with service function 2. Okay, so that's all for the demonstration. And okay.
So each service chain, you're adding service chains per client, per node. Yeah? So each time you do that, that's adding a number of flows across all open flow switches. Right? Or no?
That is like adding much more VPN configuration because VPN is not a proactive flow installation, it's a reactive installation. What you do is you create a VPN configuration based on the number of services that you have. But what he's asking is still, do you configure the flows for the traffic redirection on the open flow switches? No, that's what I mentioned. So it's reactive. So only when there is a requirement, we add the flows in the
The point of the question is, as you add more clients and service chains, the number of flows in almost all the switches grows.
Yeah.
Yes.
To
million clients.
Yeah, for example, to decrease the number of flow entries, within feature use set idle timeout. So
okay.
And also we can aggregate some flow into the data.
Yeah, it's not unreasonable that you can have a million clients with active traffic. So my question is, as the clients grow, you see the flows in all the switches grow. The number of flows in these open flow switches is a function of the number of clients, right?
Yeah, in this in the Lithium implementation, the answer is yes. Yeah, but technically, open flow controller can understand the whole network. So, the open flow controller distributes flows to other paths. Yeah, so I mean there are many techniques to decrease the number of flow entries.
Sorry, so related to that question, the match conditions, they presumably don't have to be, the rules don't have to be host specific, is that right? Because you have M patterns rather than specific hosts. I guess what I'm trying to say is to reduce the number of rules of matching patterns. Is it possible to use patterns rather than individual IP addresses? So, for example, could you say,
We can specify a kind of a range of IP address. Yeah, we can do it. Yeah. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, and as I said, you can also use other field like MAC address, TCP port, UDP port, yeah. Yeah. So even there are traffic from the same host.
Yeah.
So we can use TCP port, TCP source port, or UDP destination port, or HTTP code like that. So we can distinguish these traffic and apply different service chain.
It's only layer 2 to layer 4, right? Can you go up to layer 7?
No, right now we are using OpenFlow, so. That's all. Any question? By default, VTN manager choose shortest path. But VTN manager also provides a way to change this policy. So VTN manager provides other algorithm to choose the path, not only shortest path. So you can, for example, how to say, you can specify the weight to each link. Yeah, like that, yeah.
So initially you don't install any flows, but as soon as the traffic hits the switch, will send the packet to the controller, then the controller
will install it. Yes. Could you say again? So in this case, you just change this IP address field of this configuration. So this is a way like that.
We know how to do that. For this,
Okay, that's all. Thank you for listening. Thank you.